That is the call of one of the largest woodpeckers in the world, and, quite possibly, the largest in North America. Stay with me for the rest of the video to learn a little bit more about this stunning yet timid pileated woodpecker. First of all, the term pileated refers to the conspicuous red crest of both males and females of all ages. The word pileated also has much regional variation in its pronunciation, as it is commonly known as pileated in other accents. Pileated, pileated, potato, potato, whatever you prefer, the bird still shows off its flashy red crest throughout mature forests across much of the eastern United States, the Pacific Northwest, and southern Canada. Take a look at this range map courtesy of the wonderful website allaboutbirds.org, brought to you by the Cornell Lab of Ornithology. Here is an example of a mature deciduous forest that pileated woodpeckers love. But do you know what they love even more? Knock knock jokes. Or a good drum solo. Those pileated woodpeckers sure know how to rock the forest with their percussion skills. But in all seriousness, they rely on dead trees to survive. If you see a single snag, as they call them, in the middle of a forest, please leave it there if it's safe to do so. Countless species depend on these former trees to build homes in and raise families in. It's magical to know that a tree's life only begins when it dies. Even fallen trees are important to these creatures. They attract many insects and bugs to the decaying matter inside, thus capturing the attention of the woodpecker predators. It's one of the best ways to attract a pileated woodpecker naturally, leaving the rotten tree for nature to clean it up. And look how hard that woodpecker's hammering. Pileated woodpeckers can peck with up to 1200 G's of force. For comparison, the fastest roller coaster in the world reaches up to only 5 G's, and the woodpecker hammers with enough force to knock out a human 12 times over. Now here's a question I get asked a lot. How can you tell males apart from females? Well, not all species are sexually dimorphic or the males look different from females, but the pileated woodpeckers are. So, the easiest way is to remember that males have a bright, vibrant red mustache, the same color as their heads, while it is dark on females. Funnily enough, the scientific term for it is literally the mustachial stripe. Additionally, males have red not only on their pilium, but it extends onto their forehead, while it's black on females. So, males have more red on their heads than the females. Regardless, all you need to remember is that males have the mustache while females don't. So, with your new knowledge, can you tell me if the following few birds are males or females? Pause. This bird has a black forehead. Did you notice that? Let me know in the comments. It also has a black mustache stripe. Those two coupled together makes this an adult female. Let's try another one. Okay, here's another bird, and I'll give you a hint in 3 seconds. So, it has a black forehead, just like the previous bird. It also has a black mustache. Not all at once, it's a female. Here is our last bird, our third and final bird, and it is foraging on the ground, which might be surprising, but if it finds a good enough stump with enough insects in it, it can often drill in there for a few minutes, and oftentimes it'll let you get really pretty close. So you can see this bird has made a few holes already on the left side of this tree. Now let's figure out if it's male or female. So the first thing to look at, or second, doesn't really matter, is whether the crest or pileum goes all the way up to their forehead. And yes, it does, and it's completely red. And the second thing, the most important thing, is the color of the mustache. And this bird has a red mustache, making this bird. Let me know in the comments what you think. Is this a male or a female with that red mustache? So, I just mentioned that these birds can sometimes let you get really pretty close. However, that's only when they're so intently focused on one particular branch that they don't even see you. Oftentimes, they'll detect you or a predator from hundreds of meters away, and then they'll promptly flee before even being seen, which is part of what sometimes makes this bird so elusive. Did you catch that at the end of the last clip? When pileated woodpeckers fly, they have big white patches under their wings visible from when you're standing under them. They flap sort of like an intent crow, being of similar size, but the big patches of white are a dead giveaway that you have a woodpecker. You can also make out the two parts of its thick tail, which helps woodpeckers stabilize themselves as they climb up trees. And this isn't just pileated woodpeckers. Many other birds, like red-bellied woodpeckers, downy woodpeckers, hairy woodpeckers, just to name a few, also have tails in similar shapes like this. For example, here's a picture of a red-bellied woodpecker. Take a look at that notched tail as it climbs up a tree for stabilization. Like the red-bellied woodpecker, pileated woodpeckers eat mostly insects, including ants, beetle larvae, termites, among others. However, when bugs are scarce, they can occasionally be seen supplementing their diet with nuts and berries. You heard the calls of the woodpecker at the very beginning, but what do they mean? When pileated woodpeckers make that rambunctious call lasting only a few seconds, they're saying hello to all the pileated woodpeckers in the neighborhood. And oftentimes, to be polite, the local pileated woodpeckers will greet the bird back. Sometimes, these conversations can happen very frequently, like once every few minutes, while other times, they only occur like only after several hours. They also give a quiet muttering while foraging or landing just to fill the silence or keep themselves entertained. The distinct and familiar low-sounding drum of these woodpeckers, on the other hand, are declarations of territory. This is why it's common to see them on hollow metal buildings, which resonate the loudest, making them the most dominant woodpecker in town. When they drum, up to 25 times per second, they are not excavating their holes, rather they're letting everybody know that they live there and any competitors should stay back. When they are excavating holes, it's like a different non-rhythmic sounding drum, and it's much quieter compared to this very loud and boisterous drumming. Pileated woodpeckers are currently listed as least concern by the International BirdLife Rating. However, as more and more forests are cut down and their favorite dead trees are removed, their populations may not be as stable in the future. Regardless, they're still a fairly common sight today, within the right habitat, with older trees. If you want to see one of these majestic wonders, listen for their calls and drumming. Then look for them pecking the wood off of dead trees and dead snags or fallen trees on the ground, and they can sit motionless for a long time or be very difficult to spot, so be patient. So hopefully you learned something new about the pileated woodpecker today. Probably the largest woodpecker in North America, assuming the ivory-billed woodpecker is extinct, that's a story for another day, boasts a striking crest, or pilium, at all ages. It's a skilled drummer and forager while consuming insects and occasionally nuts and berries, and supports an integral ecological niche in mature forests as they regulate insect populations. Let me know if you learned something new in the comment section, and as always, all videos, photos, and audio were taken by Barry Birding.